Hello, my name is Nilufar Rahmanova, and I am a chief of party here in Cambodia of USAID-funded Enhancing Quality of Healthcare Activity, or EQHA project. Our mission is to improve quality of healthcare system here in Cambodia, and we do it by strengthening the levers such as accreditation, competency-based education in the universities, equipping your frontline staff with modern continuous quality improvement methods. But when in March 2020 COVID-19 struck Cambodia, Ministry of Health banned any trainings and gatherings. Hospital staff and health center staff, they felt very anxious and afraid to come for training or learning or asking questions. At the same time, we were looking into what others are doing to address this issue. What we learned is that in the United States, they start to accelerate a transition from a face-to-face service delivery to telemedicine and telecoaching, telementoring, and that gave us an idea. It gave us an idea that we can introduce digital technology in hospitals to enable the hospitals to learn in a safe way. I'm very proud that now, with USAID funding, here, all national hospitals in Cambodia and majority of referral hospitals in Cambodia, they have this video conferencing equipment. So let me tell you the advantages that we are seeing. With this video conferencing equipment, they can learn in small and frequent doses. Instead of 5 days, they may have to learn in 5 weeks, every day for 2 hours. Secondly, you don't have to have only 15 people in your virtual training. Sometimes we have over 100 people from 20 or 30 hospitals joining together to learn about COVID-19 or infection control. So it enables to create a community of practice. This creates a platform where hospitals, they can continuously learn and ask questions from experts, but also learn from their peers. Here, for example, one of the Kohkong hospitals, they were the first one to set up a successful COVID-19 triage. And their example helped to accelerate that best practice in other hospitals when they shared this in that virtual learning session. Another good advantage is that now you don't have to travel a lot. You can learn from by being in your workplace, and you're being also environment friendly that way. And the last little benefit that I saw is that people who are normally shy to ask questions or give their feedback in the face-to-face training, now they're more active and they put their thoughts and questions in the chat box. So it's also a very democratizing way of learning and exchange. So I'm very excited that we are setting up this sustainable platform in Cambodia, and we are building this new culture of learning that is a great alternative to the face-to-face learning and has its own very unique benefits. And I would like to share this, and I hope this best practice will be adopted elsewhere. Thank you for your attention.
អូនបាទឲ្យចាញ់ទៅផ្ទះថ្ងៃហ្នឹង
ខ្ញុំជាហើយបាទអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យចាញ់ថ្ងៃហ្នឹងហើយចុះបងវិញ